Hi, Peem. Thanks for contacting me through my website and requesting some help over the last few months. These days you're concerned about how you're releasing the club through impact and how your left arm is working. Particularly, you think your left arm is bending coming into the ball. Now, this is quite a common fault, and the worst thing you can do is think, my left arm's bending, let's try to keep my left arm straight. There's a reason your left arm's bending. It's compensating for other faults in your swing. And that's what I want to try to explain to you in this video. Now, it starts at address. At address, your upper body is tilted too much to the left, making it difficult for you to rotate your body. So in your backswing is dominated with your arms, a lifting of your arms. You don't really rotate your body enough. So when you lift your arms get a little bit steep and high, and the club points a little bit to the left of your target in a laid off position. Now, if you were to move through the ball correctly from here, you would hit dead pulls. Your ball would go left every time. From this high position, your arms would come down a little bit outside, the club would be a little steep. If you rotated your left shoulder and your left arm through the ball correctly, as I say, you would hit straight pull shots every time. What we need to do is shallow out your backswing and shallow out your downswing so you're able to rotate through the ball correctly. You see, if you're coming down outside, through practice, you will learn not to rotate your left shoulder, not to rotate your left arm into the ball. That's what causes the lack of release to the club. It's what causes your left arm to bend. You do this to keep the club head inside the ball. If you were to rotate, the club would come outside the ball, your swing path would be hard in, say you'd hit pull shots from the front. Say when your arms are high, club's coming down a little bit outside, it's more this movement into the ball, left shoulder raising up into high position, left arm will bend due to the left arm not being able to rotate. Now what I want you to do, starting at address, is I want you to tilt your upper body to the right a little bit. And now opposite to what you have been doing, I want you to feel like you're dominating your backswing, you're controlling your backswing a little bit more with the rotation of your body. I want to improve how much you're rotating your shoulders. So your arms will do very little. You'll control your backswing more with rotation, allowing your arms to fold and rotate around your body into a lower position. It'll feel a little flatter to you. Now from here, you will feel like your arms come down a little more behind your body in a shallower position. And hopefully from here, you can see that you will now be able to rotate your left shoulder, open your left shoulder more behind you. You'll be able to rotate your left arm into impact to hit a shot down your target line. So lower position, arms will feel more behind you. Now you can let your shoulder open up. You can let your left arm rotate into impact. And it's that which will cure your arm bending before impact and you not being able to release the club head. When you'll do this, you'll start to get a little bit of a lower ball flight, with a little more penetration, more solid contact, and we'll hopefully lose those high, weak miss shots to the right. So as I say, don't look for a quick fix. Don't just think my arm's bending. Let's try to keep it straight. Another thing you've said is you thought it might be that you're not creating enough lag in the downswing. Well, from looking at your swings before, I think you create enough lag. Seeing you come down here halfway, your left arm's straight, you've got a lot of lag angle. It's through the ball you lose it because of your backswing being a little steep, the club being a little outside. That's why you lose it through the impact zone. So hopefully with this video, you'll be able to get to work on the right things, and that's going to help you improve your game over the winter time, get you ready for next season. Okay, let's try to relate what I've said in my video up to now, just having a look at the swings from before. I know the quality's not that good, but we'll still be able to see what I've been trying to explain.
First of all, address this position where your upper body is tilted towards the target. Try to feel like your right hip's closer to the target and in a lower position, allowing your upper body to tilt away from the target. That's important to be able to improve your ability to rotate. Now, if I got a little more detailed about your rotation, if we look at your right hip, the pocket in your shorts, you'll see that it almost remains in a fixed position from where it was at address to where it is at the top of the backswing. If you were rotating correctly, your pocket would be moving more behind you. You would be feeling more of an increase in pressure underneath your right heel. So it's this which creates this look to your arms where they lift up in the backswing into a little bit of a higher position than ideal. Also, the club lays off and points to the left. So if you were to, as we said before, make a more orthodox, more normal movement through the ball, your club would come outside, swing path would be to the left. If you were to rotate your left arm correctly through the ball, you would hit shots that start left and stay left nearly every time. But you've learned to compensate. You'll see here, first of all, transition. You've got enough lag. Your left arm's straight at this point. It's through the ball. You'll now start to compensate. Your left shoulder will start to work up rather than rotate. Your left arm will start to bend to keep the club head inside the ball. It's not that severe, don't worry. Just an improvement in address and shallowing out your arms in the backswing and downswing, I think we'll see quite a quick improvement with this. So you can see the left shoulder working up rather than rotating out of the way. That's also why your hands look a little high, making it difficult to release the club face. So hopefully that's quite clear to you. I'm now going to suggest a drill you can do to help you have the feeling of letting your body rotate more, letting your right hip rotate more behind you, increasing the pressure in your left heel, and also just the same, using that feeling to help your arms shallow out in the downswing so you can start to rotate through the ball correctly.
Okay, having a look at your swing, I think this is the best drill you can do to try to improve the faults we've talked about. I want you to take an alignment rod or even an old golf club and put it at an angle to where you're about to align to hit the shot. Place under your right foot, under your right heel, the alignment rod, and then under your left toe. Now, these are two key pressure points in the swing, right heel, left toe. If you're rotating correctly in the backswing, if your right hip is rotating and rotating behind you, you will feel an increase in pressure underneath your right heel. The alignment rod will give you an increased awareness of that. So you'll be turning your right hip, so the pressure will increase under your right heel. You'll see when you do that, because of the improved rotation, that's going to help your arms work around your body. Now from here, so our body stays a little more closed for longer, we don't open our body so quickly, and we get a good transfer weight to our left foot. And I want you to increase the pressure under your left toe. Again, the alignment rod or the club shaft's going to give you an increased awareness of that. It'll be that a movement will allow your arms to come down a little bit more behind your body into a shallower position. And as we've talked about before, hopefully with a little bit of luck, you'll now start to rotate your left shoulder, left arm through the ball better, improving your release, improving your left arm position. So, alignment rod under your feet, right heel, left toe. Learning to improve your rotation. Right hip's going to work more behind you, increasing the pressure under your right heel. From here, increase the pressure under your left toe. That'll keep your arms more behind you in a shallower position. Say, with a bit of luck, we'll now be able to rotate through the ball better, improving your release, improving the way your left arm's moving.